marvelous, Jules. Thank you. You're going to make Colonel Hogan very happy.
What kind of a cake is Lebeau baking?
What kind did you have in mind?
I thought maybe he would bake a German chocolate cake.
Serve Colonel Hogan German chocolate cake? Would you offer Adolf Hitler an American cheese sandwich on Russian rye?
Whatever Lebeau bakes, it's good enough for me.
It's very big of you, Schultz.
Now I have to go back to the post.
Hi, fellas.
What's the matter? You guys look like you got a Dear John Chain letter.
No, the mail didn't arrive yet.
Colonel Hogan?
Yeah?
I'm afraid we're going to have to tell him, chaps.
I don't think we should.
Well, he's going to find out sooner or later.
Hold it, fellas. I already know.
He found out sooner.
It's the first surprise birthday party I've ever had.
Well, we've got another surprise for you, Colonel.
What's that?
Well, we were having trouble deciding what to get you, and, well, we thought it might be nice to give you a present of an ammo dump.
If it's any help, I'm 40 regular in an ammo dump. Ammo dump!
This was based on some information we got about a radar station in Braunschweiger Pass.
Where'd you get the information?
Yesterday. I heard Oxtetter telling Klink.
That's great. That is great. You walked right into their trap.
Yeah, we radioed London, and they've arranged for a bombing mission tomorrow.
Now, unless we can knock out that radio detection truck outside, we can't get word to London to call off the mission.
We hate to spoil your birthday, Colonel. We had everything all planned. Lebeau even baked a cake.
Oh, yeah, I did.
Look, we've even got the candle. See? And we've got some party hats. Oh, and I made a pin the tail on the donkey set.
Important thing is to find a way to knock out that radio trucker. An awful lot of guys are going to miss their next birthday.
Maybe we could set fire to the truck.
Yeah, we could never get close enough. They have another way.
What's that, sir?
Klink has given permission for the sentimental Americans to have a surprise birthday party for their colonel.
Oh, yeah?
You have your party, and you give your beloved colonel some fireworks.
So we load the candles.
Right. A couple of nice, big, fat Roman candles in the center of the cake.
Would you believe grown men behaving like that? You'll never see Himmler or Goering popping corn.
Why not? It looks like fun.
Schultz, you can light the candles now.
Yeah, I will. Regularly.
Light that one first, if I were you.
Wait. Fellas, I realize that we're a long way from home and sort of on our own and all that, but even so, even though we don't have all the right things and don't even have a pony or anything, there are still certain proper traditions we should observe about birthdays, and one of them is this. It's the most important. Colonel Hogan is supposed to make a wish.
I made the wish. Light the cake.
Stand over here, you see, so the guards in the tower can see.
Oh, yeah. Hey.
Here we go.
Papa Bear to Goldilocks. Papa Bear to Goldilocks. Scratch Braunschweiger Pass mission.
Something is wrong with the radio truck. Schultz, why are you standing there? Go see what happened.
Jawohl, Herr Kommandant! Please, Colonel Hogan, save me a big piece of cake.
Yeah, okay, Schultz.
Why don't you cut the cake?
With pleasure, Newkirk. I want to thank you fellas for giving me the nicest birthday party I've ever had.